I am literally having the best time. I know some of you are like, we gotta get the fuck out of here. I'm trying, but I'm having so much fun. This rarely happens where I get to just indulge. So, all right. I know, right? That was like a sinister laugh. All right. Now let's get into the murder stuff where I just tell you guys I murdered a hobo, but it's told in a joke. But I've given you some information that's probably real. Oh, damn it. When I'm out of town, sometimes if I'm staying with friends, I usually make them a deal that if you let me stay with you, I will cook. I'm an amazing cook. And so my favorite thing to do is find a butcher shop in town, go pick something out, and then I come back and I make a meal for everybody. Now, my idea of a butcher shop is very traditional. Clean white French subway tiles on the walls, a whole bunch of cold cases lined up end to end with every kind of chop and offal and trout and snotter, or snotter and trout. Anyways, yeah, just trout, lots of snotters, pig parts, I'm saying pig parts, lots of trotters and snouts. A 70-year-old retired Korean War vet, covered from head to foot in blood. Got a knife hanging off of his belt. He can't make eye contact with anybody anymore. If he sees himself reflected back in your eyes, he has to stab you. Got a lot of rage. He wraps up your meat in a white piece of paper and he passes it across the counter and you pay him and you're done. And that's how it should always be. And the last time I was here, I went to a butcher shop that I saw online. It was very close to my friend's house. When I walked in, it was all repurposed pallets on the wall and a whole bunch of hanging naked Edison bulbs and a DJ station in the corner where a guy was fucking spinning Clan of Xymox for no reason. And all I could think is, well, I'm pretty sure they don't have fucking pork chops. Okay. But I'm going to ask because I like supporting local, independent, craft-oriented artisanal businesses. I like that. I like places that locally source. I like places that have care and it goes into their craft. I love supporting those businesses. I don't like their employees. That's my problem. Look, if you own a fucking small batch coffee roaster, a record store, bike parts, or a small butcher shop, fucking customer service, okay? Get some people that understand customer service. Don't just hire a fan of that thing. Those people are dicks to everybody, okay? You don't have to... I was at a Vivace coffee place, and the woman in front of me made the mistake of ordering her coffee as a venti size, and the person on the other side of the counter lost their fucking shit on her. Venti's not a real size, that's a Starbucks size. Shut the fuck up. It's a medium, you know it's a medium, I know it's a medium. Just get her a medium, what is wrong with you? Why are you inflamed? This isn't even your business, okay? You work retail. You still work retail, you dumb hipster, okay? You still have a fucking retail job. I would have shopped at this place every time I was in Portland, if the answer to do you have pork chops was, damn it, I wish we did, we don't, I'm sorry. I know it says butcher shop, it's a little misleading, but we're trying to like recapture this sort of older artisanal sort of sense. And I mean, we do some weird stuff, we do some specialized stuff, we have a charcuterie with a little smoker in the back, make our own sausages. Oh man, we make terrines and we put them in mason jars, it's super hip right now. And have you ever had a duck fat and lavender pate? It is delicious. We have crackers, we have our own Stoneman in the back, make our own crackers, and I wish you could try that out. Damn it, I wish we had what you wanted, but next time you come to Portland, you come here and you buy that pate, okay? We'll take great care of you here. I would have shopped there all the time. Instead, what I got was, for the 33rd time today, we try to do something unique here. We don't just carry regular meat. We make terrines. If you don't know what that is, you can Google it on your smartphone. Otherwise, there's a Safeway two blocks away, and I'm sure they have your American-style pork chops. Hey, fuck you for a second. Let me give you the first rule of retail. All you have to do is be nice to my dumb face, okay? I know who I am. I know how fucking stupid I look. Be nice to me, and then stuff it down inside, and at the end of your shift, you can go and punch out of your antique time clock you bought at a vintage mall somewhere. Get on your fucking recumbent bicycle and pedal over to fucking Zooey or Ione's house or whatever your dumb hipster friends name themselves. And you can talk shit about the doughy asshole who wanted pork chops at your invite-only silk pajama party at your synth band's practice space conveniently located above a small batch absinthe distillery while you guys smoke vintage doll hair out of pipes you bought on Etsy made out of 78s of bands only three people in this room have ever heard of. I don't give a fuck if you raised your own milking pig in the back on a 1,200 thread count Egyptian cotton sheet and hand-fed it candied walnuts while the movie Brian song plays in the background on an endless loop until one day the pig just succumbs to its own ennui, holds its breath and passes quietly and painlessly in a barn made of the 1,000-year-old repurposed wood of an ancient spice trading vessel. You're being a fucking meat barista right now. Take it down a fucking notch, okay? Chicago, thank you so much for having me out. You have been the best. Thank you. Good night.